Lonely Tellians. Tellians. I don't know what we're gonna call you guys yet. Kind of sounds like a mix between aliens and televisions. I was trying to go off of my muscle tails thing and I just got Tellians, and I don't know that I like that. Let me know. Maybe you guys can name yourselves.
Will you just like go on?
It doesn't want to work, hold on. Also, like, in order to get that, like, I had to fully extend my tripod.
These are gonna be tips that helped me lose 50 pounds in a year and help to keep it off. I am still actually going. This was me a year ago. This was me, like, last week. I do have some credentials. I am not a certified personal trainer yet. I am still taking the coursework for that. You can't blame me, but I promise these will help. Mind Pump talks about these all the time as well. They're really gonna be very helpful, and they're gonna be things that you can implement throughout your daily life and continue to do over and over and over again. We're gonna have like two different outfits. I can't get the other video to like load at all. I'm gonna have to go back over my tip number one and number two because I got the other ones on my computer, so. Like, I rambled on about like 10 minutes. No, not 10 minutes. It was like 5 minutes trying to figure out my lighting in here. It's whatever. We are going to stand because we're in a hurry. I literally have to get ready for work in 10 minutes. Was not supposed to work today, but yeah, it's been a long week. It's okay, I'm taking the overtime where I can get it. Tip number one. Bitch, don't even start with me today. Tip number one is going to be drink more water. Simple as that. Aim for a gallon of water a day. If you aim for a gallon of water a day, it's gonna help flush out your system. You're not gonna be holding water weight. I promise you, you're not gonna be holding water weight because you're gonna be peeing 20,000 times a day. All the time, okay? Worry about any of that because it's gonna help flush out your system. You will be bloated the first couple of days. You're going to feel bloated. If you can make it through like the first week, really going to help. I promise you, it will help so much. It's gonna help flush all that shit out of your system. That's tip number one that I have. And then tip number two, get in more steps. If you're not taking 10K steps a day, I definitely recommend taking 10,000 steps a day. It's gonna, one, help boost your metabolism. But even if you don't go for like an hour walk, like you don't have to go for an hour walk, take like 10 minutes after each meal and go for a walk. Just walk for 10 minutes after each meal. One, it's gonna help with digestion. It's gonna help with your blood glucose levels. Can't fucking talk today. Will help with your blood glucose levels. I'm not in the mood. It will help with getting your steps in. It's gonna help with your blood glucose levels. And then along with drinking the gallon of water a day, you're gonna be getting more steps in from going to the bathroom because you aren't used to going to the bathroom as much. If you're not drinking a gallon of water, taking in, you will be doing more steps throughout the day, give or take. I don't remember if I did this as tip number three, but I don't have time to go look. There may be a fourth outfit. Number three, I believe, was, shit, I lost it. I literally bought these pants not too long ago. And look, they're already too big. They're size six. Size six, like I'm not that tiny. I still got a little bit of belly to me.
I don't understand it.
But I'm also not gonna complain.
Anyway, I still can't remember what tip number three was. Hoping it's on my computer. If not, there will be a third outfit in this video.
But yeah, that's all I got. I told you there would be a third outfit. This is the gym fit. You can't really see it too much, but it's like all black.
That's the vibes for today.
Okay, it looks like it cut off the first portion of the third tip. The third tip was to make sure that you don't eat 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed. It's gonna help you with your digestion. If you're laying down, I think I explained all this in there, but if you're laying down, your body can't fully digest the food downwards, like sink towards like the back part of your stomach, and it's not actually going to like fully like go down to where it can go out. Like you're not actually like processing it like down through your organs. What's the word I'm looking for? Productive, I guess. It can make you bloated. I've noticed sometimes that I get constipated. It really doesn't help right before you go to bed. Now, not to say that, you know, you have to do that all the time. Definitely like days before I weigh in, because I weigh in once a week during a cut, only during a cut though. Make sure that I have my water intake in and my food intake in 3 hours before I go to bed, because it helps with the getting more of an accurate weight.
That's so funny. Mike Wazowski just followed me on Instagram. We're gonna go fast. Doesn't, again, with the digestion, laying down, it's not necessarily the best thing for you. Laying down, it takes it longer to go through, whereas if you're standing up, you can just digest down. Also, with cutting the time off that you eat, it helps with those late night snacks, actually taking in less calories. Tip number four, eat your protein first. You eat your proteins first before you eat your carbs, you're going to be full more. It's more satiating, it's gonna keep you full longer, so less snacking. Why not even finish all your carbs, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. Carbs aren't essential like your fats and your proteins are. You can go without carbs. Always eat your protein before you eat your carbs because you're gonna stay full. And if you start your day off with protein, you're actually gonna be more satiated throughout the day versus if you started with carbs. A lot of breakfast food is carbs. Start off with your proteins, so like eggs. There's some other ones that I will put them here because I can't think of them off the top of my head. My phone is running out of storage because I haven't gotten everything over to my computer yet.
Also with that, you want to prioritize your protein intake over everything. Protein is probably the number one thing, even over calories. So don't want to overeat your calories. So, but yes.
I lost tip number five. It's not in my brain right now. I remembered what it is. Strength training. Lifting weights, even just 20 to 30 minutes a day. Or not a day. I'm sorry. Not a day. That's for people like me who are crazy about the gym.
Going, anywhere between 20, 30, you want to, 45 minutes. Do strength training. Weights are not going to make you bulky. They're just not. People who think, oh my gosh, like, that's so much muscle kind of thing. Most of the people that you're looking at are probably on gear or something to make them look manly. Like, I got muscles. You can't see them right now. I don't look manly. Strength training is not going to make you bulky, ladies. Train to be strong and athletic if you want to be athletic. But train to be strong is going to give you more of the look you're actually looking for. That toned look, that's what it's going to give you. It is not going to make you look bulky. Bodybuilders who you can like see like super, super defined muscles, they are at an unhealthy body fat percentage. They know it and they don't stay there. Make sure that you're training for strength versus aesthetics. So implementing 20 to 30 minutes of strength training 3 days a week will make the difference in your 10K steps a day. Drink a gallon of water. Aim for your 10K steps in your gallon of water a day. Don't eat 2 to 3 hours before bed so you have time to digest your food. It's gonna come back on your snacking. I lost the fifth one again. Oh, prioritizing your protein. The biggest things that I can give you, those are gonna be the biggest tips that I have. This video might end up being, oh my God, the burps, and they're not even good burps. But those are my five tips to help you achieve better, you know, help you achieve your weight loss. I'm still going, we're still getting there, but I'm the healthiest I've been in a long time from implementing these in throughout my life.
Okay, this is the awkward outro that I'm apparently gonna start doing because I don't know what else to do, guys. So, have a good one.